hometown visits tonight. We're getting down to the pointy end of the series on The Bachelorette. And last night, Sophie Monk put the boys, the final five, through a compatibility test, which sadly saw James as not the one for Sophie. Oh. Take a look.
Sophie, I know this is a bit of a surprise, but now you can see which chart belongs to which man. Who will not continue?
Sorry, James.
Oh, Jimmy!
I adore James. He's really sweet and caring, but he's also very serious and structured, which is very opposite to me.
Oh, James! And James joins us live in our chair.
Thank you.
Aww. Yeah. What happened? You were like the crowd favourite.
Yeah, look, I mean, I don't know. I guess going into that, I felt, you know, like we had a good connection, had a lot of momentum and was feeling great.
Yeah.
And then the group date, it just sort of, like, the cracks started to appear with that challenge there. Mm. But, I mean, too serious. You saw me dressed as Friar Tuck, right? On the, you know, performing. But, yeah, maybe a little bit.
There we go.
Oh, that was
sensational.
But, yeah, look, maybe a little organised, but not over the top.
Yeah.
Do you have a file of facts?
No.
Okay, so yeah. Story checks
do you,
out.
Do you colour code your shirts?
No. Like 80% of the week, my clothes are on the floor.
Okay, and then you just use the term 80% of the week. So
well, yeah, there we
but
go.
But that's okay to be a bit organised.
Oh, 100%.
How are you feeling? Because it must be really hard. Like, my heart breaks a little bit for you.
Yeah, look, I mean, I think it's been quite some time, so I was feeling pretty good about it all. But the last week's probably been bit tough having to like go back into that and watching it last night. I had Lukey and Manly and yeah, he gave me a bit of a man hug, so that was good. Yeah.
You come across as the sweetest and kindest guy, and you did on the show.
Thank you.
But did you have a real good connection with Sophie?
Well, I felt that we did. I can't speak for her. I mean, it indicated that we did, and I mean, you can only go by, you know, how you feel.
Yeah.
And you know, I think really at our single date, that kind of really, you know, was there.
Whoa.
Could you feel yourself starting to fall in love with her? Because lots of boys go on the show for the Instagram likes.
Yeah.
They're jerks.
Yeah, no, look, I
agree. Were you there for love?
Yeah, genuinely there to see if it would work and both ways. And for me, I think that, you know, yeah, falling in love is a journey. And I was probably on that, I was well on that path, you know, because you spend quite a bit of time and everything. So it's hard to walk away.
Mm. How do you... I always find this bizarre. How do you do that when there's a whole lot of other blokes around?
I think you've got to put yourself in someone else's shoes. So the whole time I kind of had a bit of respect for her and how hard it would be, especially as a woman in an environment surrounded by 20 blokes.
Oh, she can hold her own.
Testosterone.
No,
she's great.
Yeah.
But just a bit about it being overwhelming and how everyone's trying to get at you for a chat. So I kind of just stood back and gave us some...
It's also strange... Sorry, I didn't want to interrupt. But it's also strange how the blokes, with the exception of the sort of intruders who were seen as the, you know, the outsiders, the Johnny-come-latelys, it wasn't fair. It was almost like they had an unfair advantage in a game of football.
Mm.
But for the blokes who were there from the beginning, they were all... You all kind of bonded together. Like, you were all pretty...
The bromances.
And, like, it's weird that you were like, all right, guys, let's win this thing.
Well, no, the bromance was real. And I think I always said, look, it's not like a running race. I can't run faster than you and win.
Yeah.
It's about what Sophie's feeling.
Who she connects with.
Yeah, and who she connects with.
So you talk about feelings. Oh,
James, what star are you?
I'm a cusp, so I'm like a bit of Virgo and Libra. So I'm like...
Oh, darling.
See, no wonder he's so organised.
Are you a tiny Virgo?
I'm a messy Virgo, but I'm still organised.
I'm
still a Virgo.
You are gorgeous. You've got this killer smile, and I reckon you look a little bit like Bradley Cooper. You know the Hollywood star Bradley Cooper?
Yes.
I think we've got a photo of him
you
now
do
to compare
like
him.
Uncanny.
Yes.
Is that Sophie Monk next to you?
there would not be a shortage of gals lining up to date you.
Look,
or have you got a date?
No, I haven't. I was quite good. I've been kind of head down, laying low. I didn't want to give away the ending.
Yeah.
And, even this past week, everyone's sort of, on the street being like, we've got you pegged to the end. And, the guys in the house had said the same thing. So it was a real shock. And, I didn't want to kind of ruin it for anyone. Mm. So I've sort of been laying low.
So organised of you.
Yeah, because the hometown visits, are coming up.
Yeah.
Are you disappointed that Sophie didn't get a chance to meet your family?
I'm disappointed she didn't get a chance to meet them. I mean, they're so lovely and funny as well. But having said that, I'm kind of glad that if she's sort of already knows, maybe if she's made her mind up, that I'm going now rather than having to go through that, because it would be so hard for me to walk away going in deeper. So it's kind of like a blessing in disguise than if it wasn't meant to be.
Carlotta's available to meet the family. You know, there are so many women up there taking snaps of you from
they've come out of the woodwork. They've come out of the woodwork.
Every single female. It's like, I had no idea we had so many women working. It's unlike anyone else when they're sort of falling in love with someone.
Yeah.
But you have to, go through it all on TV and then, of course, watch it all back on TV.
Yeah.
Do you even once you've been, you're off the show and you're watching it back, do you sort of, A, fall in love with Sophie a bit again, or B, get a bit jealous of the guys that are still there? Do you still have those normal, the normal emotions you'd have in the real world, or is it just kind of, now just a television show?
No, look, definitely A. I mean, like, going back into it, she's such a beautiful person inside and out, and hilarious, she's just so witty and on. And so watching it back and then hearing her comments for the first time, it's been awesome, and just to see that. No jealousy, because, the reality of the situation, if you've got a level head, is, she's here to find somebody. There's 22 people. She's going to want to date everyone. Mm. And so you've got to kind of have faith, be yourself and be grounded.
New age as well. Is he new age, he is single and ready to mingle. Bachelorette at 7:30 tonight on the 10 and Win Network.
And we'll be putting James's mobile number on our Facebook page.
James, thanks for joining us.
Thank you. Lovely to meet you guys. Thank you.
Thank you.